Hello and welcome to Forward Kids Online. My name is Miss Shanita and I'm so excited to be sharing an awesome lesson with you today. Who remembers last week when we took our first trip around the world? Who can remember where we went to? That's right, it was Australia. And today, I want you guys to get ready, buckle up tight, because we are heading to New Zealand. I love New Zealand because it's the place of my birth, and I know that it is such an awesome place to grow up. But here are some fun facts that I'm going to share with you today. Did you know that in the South Island, the biggest mountain is Mount Aoraki, Mount Cook? And guess how tall it is? It's 3,754 meters high. Oh my goodness, that's gigantic. Did you also know that the capital of New Zealand is Wellington? And that's where the big, big beehive is, where the Prime Minister works in. How interesting is that? Did you also know that New Zealand is home to one of the biggest whales and biggest dolphins as well? It's home to the killer whales, it's home to the humpback whales, and home to many, many dolphins. How beautiful is that to know? Well, how about you share all of those fun facts with your family and friends who haven't been to New Zealand? That's such a good idea. Well, how about we buckle up and get ready to do some praise and worship? Yay!
Waking up to another light, no more sorrow and no more night. You're the light, let it shine now, let it shine now. Burning bright cause we're not ashamed, got a world to illuminate. You're the light, let it shine now, let it shine now.
Are you ready? Nothing can stand against us. that light shining. Come on, let's fill this room with light. Let's fill this room with light. Woo! Something's changing the atmosphere tonight. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? Come on, we're going to sing Shine Light together.
Shine a light, shine a light. 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 We got a light and we gonna shine. Jesus, please make me glorify. We got a light and we gonna shine. Forever, please make me glorify. We got a light and we gonna shine. Jesus, please make me glorify. We got a light and we gonna shine. Forever, please make me glorify.
Get up, let's get it started. Time to move around, let's have a party. Move to the left, move to the right. Feel the beat and hang on tight. Move to the left, move to the right. Feel the beat and hang on tight. Now stop and clap it out. Now stop and stomp it out. Now stop and bounce it out. Now stop and shout it out.
Get up, jump up, turn up and dance. Gonna praise you, Jesus, with all that I am. Get up, jump up, turn up and dance. Gonna praise you, Jesus, with all that I am.
Come on, get up, let's get it started. Time to move around, let's have a party. Move to the left, move to the right. Feel the beat and hang on tight. Move to the left, move to the right. Feel the beat and hang on tight. Now stop and clap it out. Now stop and stomp it out. Now stop and bounce it out. Now stop and shout it out. Yeah.
Jump up, turn up and dance. Gonna praise you, Jesus, with all that I am. Get up, jump up, turn up and dance. Gonna praise you, Jesus, with all that I am. Get up, jump up, turn up and dance. Gonna praise you, Jesus, with all that I am. Get up, jump up, turn up and dance. Gonna praise you, Jesus, with all that I am.
Wow, what beautiful voices you have, and what cool dance moves you're doing. Well, we are going to get into my personal favorite part of the lesson, and that is our Bible reading for today. How about you take some time now to go and get all of your favorite pens and all of your favorite notebooks and a Bible so that we can read together today. Today, we are reading from Genesis 4, verse 1 to 6. This is a story about Cain and Abel. Cain and Abel are sons to both Adam and Eve. Cain was someone who didn't really trust the Lord and didn't obey God's orders, while Abel was a son who loved the Lord and he obeyed all of the Lord's commandments. One day, God asked Cain and Abel to offer a sacrifice to the Lord to show their love and their obedience. Just like how sometimes we need to show obedience and love to our parents. Cain did not obey. We're going to look at a story now about what happens when you don't obey God. Let's take a look now.
After being driven from the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve started their tough life on the earth, tilling the soil, cultivating vegetables and fruits, keeping cattle of different types, and so on. After some time, Eve gave birth to their first child. They named him Cain. Years passed by. Now Cain has got a little brother too. His name was Abel. Both grow bigger, helping their parents in farming. Cain was more interested in tilling the soil and cultivating different types of plants, whereas Abel took interest in keeping the flocks. Abel was a very pleasant boy, showing affection even to his cattle. And you know, there was an unhealthy competition growing up in Cain's mind towards his brother, as we see nowadays in most of the families. Abel was so generous in all his deeds, showing his respect and love to God, his parents, his brother, and even to his sheep. One day, Abel came with a fat, smart goat for the offering to God.
Yahweh, my Lord, please accept my small offering. Thank you so much, Lord, for blessing me with the healthy flocks I have. Everything I have is out of your mercy alone.
Cain brought a basket full of vegetables and fruits to God while he was walking across his garden. The vegetables seemed not to be fresh. God received the basket and looked at it, and then at Cain. Sometimes we too do the same in our everyday life, don't we, friends? Now Yahweh was well pleased with Abel and his offerings, but towards Cain and his offerings, he showed no pleasure at all. This made Cain very angry and downcast.
Cain, why are you angry and downcast? If you do right, why do you not look up? But if you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin is lurking at the door. Its desire is for you, but you must control it.
Abel, come on. Let's go to the fields. I will show you something that is very interesting.
They both went walking. Once they reached a no man's land, do you know what happened?
Oh, my Lord! Help! Please help me, oh brother! Don't do this to me! Why are you doing this to me? Please don't kill me! Ah! Ah! Don't kill me! Please!
Yes, he's dead. Yeah, finally my biggest enemy is gone forever. Oh, I am in peace now. I am in peace.
Cain, stop there. Where is your brother Abel?
I don't know. How do I know? Am I my brother's keeper?
What have you done? I know everything. Your brother's blood cries out to me. And now you are cursed from the ground. which has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. When you till the ground, it will no longer yield to you its strength. You will be a refugee and a wanderer on this earth.
No, no, my lord. Don't punish me like this. I know what I did was wrong. Today you have driven me away from the soil, and I shall be hidden from your face. I shall be a fugitive and a wanderer on the earth, and anyone who meets me may kill me. Lord, have mercy on me, please.
Well, at least you have agreed that you are guilty. But sorry, I can do only this much for you. Whoever kills you, they will suffer vengeance 7 times of it.
Yahuwah put a mark on Cain so that no one who came upon him would kill him. Then Cain went away from the presence of the Lord and settled in the land of Nod, east of Eden. This is the story of Cain and Abel, and there began the first crime on earth. And you know, friends, it's happening every day, every minute, again and again around us. We are all the children of the great Almighty. If so, can't we bother a bit about our siblings too?
Wow, what a powerful message on how important it is to obey God and to love Him with all of our hearts. Today, I want to remind you how important it is to not only love ourselves, but love our neighbors even more. And that God has given you the decision to make great choices. That is called wisdom. And wisdom comes from the Lord. Where does wisdom come from? The Lord! Well, how about you put your pens and paper down as we finish in prayer. Are you ready? Put your hands together like this. Close your eyes. And let's pray. Father, I thank you that you love us. I thank you for your wisdom. I thank you that you help us to make the right choices. Help us this week, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. Well, I want you to make some great choices this week and remember to use wisdom. Have a great week and I'll see you next time. Bye.